Hi Miss Radhika and hi Miss Jayashri. Tell us something about Little Steps.
The Little Steps was it was started by myself and Radhika. We were just on a trip for our college. We were college mates actually. So we were just going on a trip to our college, college after I think 30 long years. Yeah. It was during that trip that we, you know, the whole idea came, and then we thought that why not we start something. I have a lot of experience in abacus. I have been into franchising, I have been into marketing, I have been into finance and administration. And Radhika basically was into teaching. She has been teaching for 30 years in Kuwait. So we thought why not put both of these together and then start our own venture. And that is how, you know, Little Steps came about. And it was in October 2011 that we started this venture. So when we started, we had only 3 children. Mm-hmm. And today, we have about 23 children, which I think is a very big growth in itself. And that speaks for the quality and for what we stand for. So I think it's a very good progress, and we would do much better. I hope we will do much better in the future years to come. And we do have a dream of maybe one day making this into a bigger school, maybe till the primary level, which I think should materialize.
What makes it so unique?
When we started the school, it was only the idea of having a nursing school, which is different for this place. And we are not in competition with any of the other schools here. That is not our idea. But when we wanted to provide a nursery school which has all that I have seen outside, like she said, I've been working for nearly 30 years as a teacher. Out of this last 10 years, I was the vice principal in charge of the primary section of the school, meaning I used to set up the nursery schools everywhere. And what I noticed was children learn more through touching and handling and feeling things than just studying. And even so when we took this place up, when we decided to turn it into a school, we decided that from outside it shouldn't look like some place the children can come and play, you know, painting things on the outside. So we can attract people, but then so does the other places that they can simply have fun. We wanted it to be totally meant for education as such, but in a very child-friendly way. So we made sure that the outside of the school is as useful and educative as the inside of the school. We have a garden where the children will maintain the grass at a very nice level. So at every point of the year, they learn to touch grass. We have a sand pit where they can feel the sand. We made sure there are plants of every kind with different colored flowers. So they learn the colors of flowers and they learn to touch flowers. We also have little bits of, you know, later on when you go to see, you will notice little pots. The children plant the seeds and they water it and they see it grow, see the flowers and see the fruits that come out of it. And these are all for the outside. This is besides the usual cycle and the horse and the seesaw. The inside of the house was also, inside of this area, was painted in such a way that at any point in any place in the room, they can have a study section. They have the alphabets on the wall. They have a story painted on the wall. They have a small library on one side. You know, and then they have the desk, each one, they have a restaurant style seating for dining area so that they learn to sit in one place and eat. These are all very important things which have to be taught when they are very young, and they should be taught very casually. It should become a part of their life. When you sit to eat, take out your napkin. When you sit to eat, you have one person sitting in front of you. You do not interfere with his food, and he doesn't interfere with yours. You don't spill things on the floor. So when they learn to sit in a group of 4, they see how the others eat, they see what the others eat, and then they get tempted to eat fruits. You know, a child who never eats fruits may like to see somebody else eat it and learn to eat it. So even that becomes a learning situation there. So we make sure they sit in small groups of 4 or 5 and they eat. And then they have their concept room where they are taught certain concepts, which is different from a playroom. Each area is clearly differentiated so that when they go into a concept room, they know they are going to study something there. When they come to the TV room, it's fun time. When they come to the lunch room, that's only for breakfast and lunch. They don't play there, they don't write there. The same way when they come outside, they are totally monitored. We have kept the teacher-student ratio as to 5-6 is to one teacher and one helper. So we have more than, we have three teachers and three ladies to look after for even 18 students. I think this is what makes it a little unique for all of us. We don't overcrowd our rooms. We make sure that every child has at least two chairs that they can, we have more than 16, more than 20, 25 chairs here, even though the number of children are less, so that they have a choice of color. Even there they learn different colors, different tables, this is mine, that is theirs. That kind of, that's what we think makes the school unique. That, I think, is what is necessary in this particular day and, you know, in this situation right now in the world, because that's what children miss everywhere.
We don't follow a particular curriculum. I mean, that's very important. I think we need to mention. We don't follow a particular curriculum. So it is a mixture of many things. I mean, whatever is suited for the children of today's, you know, this period of time, it is going to be useful for them in the future. And so we have combined everything. So we are neither follow the Montessori method, nor do we follow the Playway method. It's a combination of both. So that in the future, when the children go out from here, they are, you know, well equipped with whatever is required of them when they go to other schools. So that is what is another feature that makes it very unique. Because most of the play schools, if you see, they either follow the Montessori method, they are too much into Montessori method, which again we feel is not suited to Indian traditions and Indian children. So that is one thing which makes us very, very unique.
They are not forced to study, they are not forced. We do not force them to pick up the pencil or pen and write when they are in nursery. As far as I am concerned, they only learn it through experience, not just Playway. Everything is not just Playway, even through teaching. And the whole thing is totally child friendly. The child doesn't struggle to learn the different habitats of animals or different kinds of shapes. They are introduced to it very casually and in a very friendly manner so that they don't struggle. They should feel happy to come back. We hardly have crying children with us. They do not cry for more than half a day. Our teachers are very dedicated.
And they do follow whatever we, you know, tell them. They follow that same method.
Safety, as regards safety, safety teachers everywhere. Nobody is
going to be the other helping staff, they are all very cooperative. I think so we should mention that, because they are being very cooperative.
Well equipped, and you know, the cleanliness level that is maintained here, I would say it is really, really high standard. You know, all the parents can come and have a toilet any time in the day, it will remain the same. It's not towards the end of the day it's bad or smells, or they can come and check it any time. That kind of cleanliness is maintained by us throughout. That's our priority. The children do not fall sick. They are taught to wash their hands before they eat, after they eat, before they go to the toilet, after they come out of the toilet, they wash their hands, they learn it. And it's all at their level. So the whole thing is child friendly. That I think is our plus point.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.